These are the Belcher Islands, an archipelago in the Hudson Bay of Canada. These islands are actually situated near the center of the Nazca Polka Arc, which I've already discussed in another video. And one thing that immediately becomes apparent when you see these islands is the weird folded shape that these islands take up. It looks as though somebody might have painted these on the landscape, or an iPad kid had a chocolate bar and smeared it on their iPad. And so, let's take a deep dive into how these islands formed. Now, these islands were actually formed by a multitude of geologic processes that all worked together to form these weirdly shaped islands that we see today. The first of these processes was the deposition of the sabka, which is the bedrock in this case, of the islands. And a sabka is essentially a salt flat, mainly caused by evaporation. And the deposition of the sabka took place around 2.01 billion years ago, and it actually has the first signs of cyanobacteria. Now, this Casagal formation is just one of many of the formations that we can see today on the island's many sediments. However, at the time when it was formed, it did not have the folded shape we see today. So how did it get folded? Well, it was folded in the same event that we saw the Nazca Polka Arc form, and this is the Trans-Hudson Orogeny. Now, an orogeny is essentially a mountain-building event. And so in the blue here, it's kind of hard to see, but there is the Trans-Hudson Orogeny. Now, this Trans-Hudson Orogeny had this area called the Belcher Fold Belt. A fold and thrust belt is a specific type of orogeny, and it forms when two tectonic plates collide into each other. It's kind of like if you were to push a piece of paper in and it would create a bunch of folds. One example of a fold and thrust belt are actually the Appalachian Mountains. And as you can see, these mountains are surprisingly uniform, creating essentially a pattern of hills and valleys and largely a sinuous type formation. This fold and thrust process is the same process that formed the Belcher Islands that we can see up here. Essentially, as the Belcher Fold Belt was coming into contact with a larger part of the Superior Craton, it was folding, which created most likely pretty big mountains from this Casagallic formation we had seen before. And as we can see on the stratigraphic map, this was an extremely long process, as many different sediments appeared in the area, including basalt formations, which are igneous formations that form due to volcanic activity. And so at this stage, we likely have Appalachian-like mountains throughout this entire area. But as we can see today, of course, this is just a small section of the island. So how did they get down to be this section? Well, as I mentioned previously, these fold and thrust mountains most likely formed anywhere from 2 to 1.8 billion years ago. This means that these islands have had significant time to erode. And so with a combination of the waters rising and waves beating against the mountains and glaciers coming in and scraping the landscape, it has only left behind the strongest of the sediments that were deposited here. So that is the most widely accepted theory. However, there were some other theories that were suggested on how these islands formed. For example, Carlisle Beals, the same person that suggested that the Nazca Polka Arc was formed by an ancient impact structure, suggested that the Belcher Islands were the central peak of this impact structure. Of course, his theory that the Nazca Polka Arc was an impact structure was found to be untrue. Another theory suggested that instead of a fold and thrust zone, this was a section where continents had actually pulled apart, so a rift zone, quite the opposite of a fold and thrust zone. But of course, there is really no way to know truly how these islands formed. And so, the debate surrounding the formation of the Belcher Islands still remains today. But now, when you guys are looking at satellite view of Hudson Bay, I hope you are able to marvel at this geologic mystery. If you have any video ideas, comment them below, and I'll see you in the next video.